Good morning, everyone. So our today's topic of discussion is tissue microarray, which is a very recently developed research tool. So it being a research tool and we being pathologists, we need to have some basic information about it. So starting with it, the technique of tissue microarray is a high throughput, which means highly efficient research tool, which was developed to facilitate and accelerate the process of tissue analysis. Tissue microarrays are a means of combining hundreds of specimens of tissue onto a single slide for the purpose of simultaneous analysis. So here in this picture, you can see the slide where there are multiple tissues arranged in an orderly manner. This is a tissue microarray slide. Tissue microarray technique is a method of relocating tissues from the conventional histologic blocks to a new empty paraffin block. Conventionally, whenever we are studying our cases in histopathology and neuropathology, what we have is each individual case is having individual slides. In tissue microarray, what we have is multiple tissues are arranged on a single slide, that is multiple cases on a single slide. So this explains the statement that tissue microarray helps in facilitating and accelerating the process of tissue analysis. So whenever some new technique is devised, it is usually the limitations of the conventional method which roots the development of a newer technique. So it was the cumbersome nature of the procedures and limited availability of diagnostic reagents and limited patient sample size which led to the development of this newer technique for tissue analysis. So back in 1986, it was Hector Batifora who for the first time gave this idea of putting multiple tissues on a single block. And his technique was known as multi-tissue tumor block technique. And he used sausage method, which means he scraped the tissue from the paraffin blocks, which looked like sausages. That's why it was known as sausage method. Later, many modifications followed. And in 1998, it was Konanen who developed the technique, which we currently are using for constructing tissue microarrays. Konanen gave this technique, which uses a novel sampling approach to produce tissues of regular shape and size that can be more densely and precisely arranged on a single block. Basically, Konanen gave a more modified, simpler, and good-looking technique than Batifora, and we are using his technique for constructions. The development of tissue microarrays is considered to be one of the most noteworthy developments in histopathology in the last decade. So according to the different making methods, tissue microarrays are classified into two, can be categorized into two, frozen tissue microarray and paraffin tissue microarray. Like in histopathology and neuropathology, we use frozen sections and normal sections, paraffin section, formalin fixed paraffin embedded sections. Similarly, the TMAs are having this frozen TMA and paraffin TMA. In frozen TMA, we are not fixing the tissue, which helps in retaining the native characteristics of DNA, RNA, and proteins. So frozen TMAs can be considered as a better tool for doing molecular studies as compared to paraffin embedded tissues. So throughout our present discussion, whenever I'll say tissue microarray, I'll be referring to paraffin tissue microarrays. Paraffin tissue microarrays are produced by tissue blocks by taking tissue blocks from tissue cores from donor blocks and re-embedding these into a single recipient block. This helps again in simultaneous analysis, and the benefit here is that the samples are studied under identical and standardized conditions on a single glass slide. This provides maximal preservation and use of limited and irreplaceable resources. The antigenicity of tissue stored in paraffin wax can be retained for up to 70 years. Now let's see how tissue microarrays are constructed. This is the basic framework. We take donor blocks, which are from our archives, and the tissues from the donor blocks are picked and placed onto the empty recipient paraffin block, and then slides are made out of it. So we'll see what are the steps involved. Whenever we are studying doing some research or doing some study, we select few cases. So after selecting those cases, we'll take out blocks and slides of those cases from our archives, and we'll re-evaluate those slides. After when we are re-evaluating, we will mark the most representative part on the slice, and then corresponding area will mark it on its paraffin blocks. Then from that marked tissue, like we can see here, this white thing, it is the marked representative area. Using a punch needle, we pick the tissue core and we transfer it into the recipient empty paraffin block. Then we do the normal microtomy, we make sections and we make slices out of it. Now here what we used is donor blocks, which we took from our archives. Then we will be needing recipient block. There are two methods of making recipient block. Either we can, two methods of making empty recipient blocks. Like we can either sit and punch out, make holes in the paraffin block, or we can use these molds, which can readily give us an empty recipient block with this orderly arranged holes. So this is the this is how we use these molds for making tissue microarray paraffin blocks. Like we place this cassette into the mold, and then we fill it with the paraffin and we let it set for 1 hour. The molten paraffin. We usually use the low melting paraffin, and we let it set for 1 hour. Then we remove the mold, and we'll get a finished recipient block. Then the rest of the steps follow. That is, we pick the tissue from donor block and place it onto the recipient block. Now, various companies make these such molds, and they provide kits like of various sizes, the molds of various sizes along with disposable needles, and it costs around 25,000 to 30,000 per kit. So, now when we are taking tissue from the donor block, we use needles. So these needles are of different sizes, ranging from 0.6 mm to 2 mm. So we can select the needle depending upon the sample size we have, depending upon the tissue we have. And then, so 0.6 mm needles are recommended for general use. And usually we avoid using larger size needles, as it might damage the block, donor tissue. If we are using 0.6 mm needles, then maximum of 500 tissue cores can be adjusted on a single paraffin block, single standard paraffin block. And if we are using 2 mm needles, then around 50 tissue cores can be adjusted on single block. The spacing between the cores is also very important. Ideal spacing should be of around 0.1 mm. So here we can see that in this first image, they used larger needles, and it destroyed the recipient block as well. And here in this block, we used smaller size needles, and even the spacing was done correctly, and this gave us a beautiful TMA slide. Now, lots of automation has been done, and they have devised these arrayers for the purpose of transferring tissue cores from the donor blocks to recipient blocks. So there are three types of arrayers. One is manual arrayer, or the Beecher's instrument. Second one is automated one, and the third is the portable quick ray arrayer. So this is the image of manual arrayer. So here what we have is there's one stage for keeping donor blocks, and one stage for recipient block. And we have two needles, one for picking the tissue from a donor block, and the other one is for punching holes in the recipient block. So here we need not use the molds for making recipient blocks, because here there's separate needle for punching out the holes. And there's this adjusting knob, and a digital micrometer is also there. Then this is an automated arrayer, where we have this stage for keeping donor blocks, this for a recipient block. Three different size needles are there, and these are the two cameras for proper localization. And this is a quick ray arrayer, where we have this needle, and there are different sized changeable tips. And these are the cassettes and templates for making recipient blocks. Then comes the next step of smoothening and sectioning. Smoothening is important, since lots of time what happens is the tissue cores which we have placed into the recipient blocks, they fall off. So to avoid that, we need to do smoothening, and also it helps in making uniform sections. So there are many methods by which we can do smoothing, but the easiest way to do it is to heat a clean slide to around 70 to 80 degrees Celsius and to touch it to the array block surface. The surface of the block will begin to melt. Then move the slides in circular motion and place the slide and block in refrigerator for some time. The sectioning of TMA slides is same as what we do in histopathology and neuropathology using the microtomy. Then we can stain. Once the block is ready, we can section it and we can do staining. Depending upon our study and purpose of study, we can stain the TMA slides. The method of staining is similar to the conventional staining only. But what all advantages it have is since all the sections on the slide are stained under using identical reagent concentrations and temperatures. Even the age of the slide, section thickness and exposure at all the steps is identical. So all the groups within one TMA are equally affected by the experimental variations, thus reducing the experimental error or bias. Once the slide is ready, then comes our data analysis part of the research. So there are two components. That is, we will analyze the slide and we'll record the data. And later, we'll do analysis of the data which we have recorded. So this is what the TMA construction is. Like, see here, there's a paraffin block. This is the mold of a paraffin block. We made a empty recipient block. Then we took donor blocks. We picked tissue using punch needles. We placed those cores into the recipient block. We made slide and then stained it. So these are the end products of TMA construction. This is the TMA block and this is a TMA slide, stained slide. Now coming to the application part, lots of research work is done using, is like not in India yet, but in many countries they do lots of research using tissue microarray technique. So we can do retrospective and prospective human tissue studies. Also, it is a very effective and practical tool for high throughput molecular studies. We can use TMAs for the purpose of researching newer biomarkers. Thus, it explains that its diagnostic utility as well. It is a good tool for basic research and also it helps in doing drug discoveries. So what are its uses of TMA for to us? Cancer or tumor research is the main application of TMA. There are three methods by which we can do it. There's this multi-tumor array technique, then tumor progression array and prognostic array. In multi-tumor array, what we do is we take multiple, if we are selecting some group of tumors, we array it on a single slide and then we can do molecular studies on it. In tumor progression array, what we can do is we can array a wide spectrum of the tissues from same organ. Like for example, if I want to do it for prostate cancer, then on the same slide, I can array the normal tissue of prostate, then benign prostatic hyperplasia tissue, then tissue from malignant prostatic carcinoma. Then we can use TMAs for tissue banking. Like not every institute has got the same kind of cases. We can find different cases in different institutes. So we can pool all those data and we can develop a tissue bank. Then we can use it for molecular studies, like I said, and quality control as well. Quality control for both internal as well as intra-laboratory quality control. Now this is IHC section where you can see that there's this internal control which we are using. So this decreases the subjective discrepancies in the findings. Now this here we can see that the tissue from different patients of invasive carcinoma, breast carcinoma, are added on the slide for the purpose of IHC characterizations. So what are the advantages of using tissue microarray? It helps in amplification of scarce resource. It helps in simultaneous analysis. It also brings in experimental uniformity. It helps in decreasing the assay volume, time and cost, and even it does not destroy the original block, thus preserving the valuable tissue. But there are certain limitations of using tissue microarray technique. The loss of tissue can occur during processing. Then even we can face unreliability in IHC staining. Small size of TMAs may not provide a glimpse of the entire tissue profile. For example, in heterogeneous cancers like adenocarcinoma and Hodgkin's lymphoma, a small tissue sample may not represent the whole tumor. A tumor tissue may comprise of many different histological areas. So it may not be possible for the small sample to represent the whole tissue pool. There are certain challenges which TMA users face. There are mechanical challenges and information management challenges. Mechanical challenges are faced by the technicians while making or constructing the TMAs. And information management are faced by the researcher or the pathologist who is recording the data. So what they have done is they have given a grid organization for TMA, where they represent individual quadrants using capital alphabets, and using number and small alphabets, they give this location of individual pores. In some laboratories, what they do is they do color coding for easy identification while data recording. And to decrease the mechanical errors, molds, they give this marker, they place this marker in the molds. Like here you can see they have made this 45 degree angle, which will help in proper, which will help the technicians in avoiding the error due to disorientation. What are the future perspectives? We can use, develop a tissue bank using by using the tissues from the tissue bank, we can do a retrospective evaluation for new tumor markers. We can develop newer modalities, treatment modalities using tissue microarray technique. Soon, automated tissue microarray construction will be available. Tissue microarray technique will allow tissue microarrays from different sources to be included in a single study, thus excluding the experimental bias. Widespread use of tissue microarray will soon become an integral part of research, and the potential use of tissue microarray technology will enable pathologists to present their well-defined historical and current archives in an added manner to the scientific community. Currently, tissue microarray technique is being used in ICMR and also in Tata Institute, but in Tata Institute, they're only allowing their own students for using this technique. Our take-home message: tissue microarray technology is a practical and effective tool for high-throughput molecular analysis of tissues, thus proving its diagnostic and prognostic use. Tissue microarray has varying degrees of research use. Even the histological quality is not compromised in paraffin wax. The routine staining, IHC, and FISH techniques do not need any modifications. TMA benefits include consistent staining of all the pores, rapid evaluation, and reduced subjectivity of selecting tissue area. That's it.